Hughes and Hromek at the line. And Besser's pass for Hughes as he moves to the middle. Now Miller, JT Miller, side of the net. They pass across and they score! Brock Besser with 2:47 left and the goalie pulled has made it a one-goal game.
Very clean execution in getting the goalie out, in getting fresh bodies on the ice. The last thing you can afford to do is kick the goalie out with a bunch of guys that are totally out of gas. That didn't happen. Good formation by Vancouver, really zipping that puck around. Boy, oh boy, did they ever open things up. And again, everyone respects JT Miller's shot, but he plays it to the right. And look who's there. Lindholm's there as a right-hand shot. My goodness, you couldn't draw this up any better than what the Vancouver Canucks just did. That is some pretty good-looking stuff right there.
So Brock Besser has both the goals in this game for Vancouver. He scored his first one 2 minutes and 55 seconds into the game, and he scores this one with 2 minutes and 47 seconds left in regulation time. Shillings is back in there as Sherwood gets it in. Puck down to 2.5 to go. Rick Tocchet comes up with a shift from Garland, Joshua, and Bluger here.
Both coaches have timeouts available.
Yep. Miller starts to get on the ice. You'd imagine this will be Shelov's cue to come to the bench again, but the stop sign for Rick Tocchet right now. Now he's waving for it. Shelov takes off. Extra attacker is on in Lindholm as Vancouver dumps it in with 2 minutes to play. Yossi all the way around the glass. Ryan O'Reilly gets it out of the zone. Hughes poked it right there. Colton Sissons with an empty net.
Oh my laundry! Holy mackerel!
Against Vancouver, but that could have been it. Still a lot of time left for the Canucks.
Unbelievable on the backhand right here, and I thought it was in from my angle, right off the pipe and out. I think even Quinn Hughes was shocked that it didn't go in the net. There wasn't anybody diving to shot to stop that. Watch Yossi's footwork here. Whoop! Thanks for coming. Boy, oh boy, he gave JT Miller the nine of hearts there with that move. And that allowed the puck to get to Ryan O'Reilly, who got the puck out. That led to the Sissons empty netter off the post.
Well, the faceoff back in the Vancouver, that means Shelov is back in his crease as well. 1:45. And O'Reilly tossed out of the faceoff and not happy about it. Lindholm and Jankowski. Sissons got body position on Hromek and comes up with that puck. Sissons trying to pin it against the end wall. Did a pretty good job of it. Now as it comes free, it's Pettersson trying to advance, but Ryan O'Reilly.
What a play with the stick. The tip of his blade, he's able to drag it back through the legs of Pettersson, who ends up falling down.
There goes Shelov with a minute 20 to go. Good news, will double back and get it set up. Of the Canucks offense in this series. Pettersson couldn't handle that puck. Roman Yossi slowed up. Nikita Zadorov is on the ice for some big front presence. This one comes out of the zone though. And Aaron Pass will have Vancouver chasing it. 50 seconds left. The pass ahead for Miller. He couldn't handle it.
Took an odd bounce off the bottom dancer.
Quinn Hughes slips away with 40 seconds to go. Hughes over the line for Miller. That shot sails wide. Garland hard around towards Miller. 30 seconds left. Miller's pass connects out high with Pettersson. Now for Quinn Hughes. Hughes right through the top of the crease and wide. Now it's Miller. 22 seconds left. Pettersson's shot. That one redirected into the corner. After it is Jankowski. Roman Yossi rimmed around. Not a lot on it. Hughes has it. He shakes free. 12 seconds left. They move it to Miller. JT Miller with a slap pass.
Oh my goodness!
It's Brock Besser! He's got all three for Vancouver! He ties it with 6.2 left!
And how about putting Zadorov in front of that net? And the confidence of the puck in just different directions and separating the defending team like the Vancouver Canucks can do. There's very few that can do that. Besser didn't give up on the play. The first shot was stopped by the goaltender. Saros went to pad. Backhand pass by Hughes. Right over there to Pettersson. Here's a shot by Miller looking for a redirection. He got it. The first one was redirected by Brock Besser. And you can keep your eye on number six. He's in the bumper position. There's the play. And then on the backhand off the side of the net. And then in on the forehand. And no one covers the goal line with the goalie out of position and losing his stick.
Set the clock to 8 seconds, but Brock Besser scores at 17:13 and at 19:52, two goals in 2 minutes and 39 seconds, and the Vancouver Canucks have forced overtime in game four.
They came from the abyss. I mean, there was nothing going on. It looked like they were going uphill with dull skates against the wind, and then bang, just like that, pull the goalie twice, great execution. And it's a tie game.
So the Vancouver Canucks, who scored on their first shot of the game and their last shot of regulation, have managed on just 19 shots to force overtime, tied at three with the Nashville Predators. What a wild ride and a strange turn this one has taken. We sent it back to the guys in our studio for an intermission overtime.